go for it.
Oh,
are you?
Smell.
Hey!
Guys, do the other way so you can.
Okay. Because your knees hurt.
Poetry.
are really drawn to relativism, and it's this. Relativism is the perfect cover-up for sin. It is a perfect cover-up for sin. You see, back in the old days, like 10 years ago, back in the old days, if you wanted to commit a sin, you had to come up with a reason why it was okay. Well, I can cheat on this test because I really need to go and hang out with my friends this weekend, and so I know it's probably bad to cheat, but I really need to do this, and so for me right now, it's okay. You had to, like, come up with a reason why. You had to rationalize sin in your brain. With relativism, you don't even have to do that. You can just say, well, this is what I believe. Adam, I know you probably say that that's wrong, but for me, it's right. You say that cheating on my test might be wrong. Well, guess what? I just say it's okay for me. So for me, it's okay. Adam, for you, it would be totally wrong. But for me, it's just okay. It is going to come back to hurt us. It always comes back to bite us. And so, guys, it is very, very important that we are making our decisions based upon truth. Truth. So grab your Bibles. I want to show you a passage this morning, real quickly, in John chapter 18. John chapter 18. This little section is happening right in the middle of Jesus' passion, and so it can get overlooked because we're thinking all about the cross and it coming up, and there's some very interesting things that Jesus says. Right before Jesus is crucified, he has run through a couple of mock trials. He has to go in front of kind of the Sanhedrin, he goes in front of the high priest, and now he's going to be up in front of Pilate. Pilate is kind of the Roman governor, okay? And he's the last line of defense. The Jews cannot crucify Jesus without the Romans' help. And so they need Pilate to sign off on them crucifying Jesus. So Pilate has a decision to make. The question of whether Jesus is going to die or not rests on him. He gets to decide. He has a choice to make in his life, a decision. So we're going to look at how Pilate makes his decision, because honestly, it's a lot how we make ours. So as he's interviewing Jesus, look at verse 36 in chapter 18 of John. Verse 36, Jesus says this. He says, my kingdom is not of this world. If it were, my servants would prevent my arrest, would fight to prevent my arrest by the Jews. But now my kingdom is from another place. You are a king, then, said Pilate. And Jesus answered, you are right in saying that I'm a king. In fact, for this reason I was born. And for this I came into the world, to testify, look at this, to the truth. Everyone on the side of truth listens to me. And look at Pilate's response. What is truth? Pilate says. What is truth? You see, Pilate is a
relative. Second place.
A fun one. Instead of bear crawling.
Second.
What?
Are we recording?
Of course.
Hey, how's it going? How you doing?
You're gonna tell me what's camp been like so far. Tell me. Okay, look, tell me. How's camp been so far?
I'm hungry.
Say again? How's camp been so far? Just tell me.
Awesome. Are you gonna follow it?
I dare you. Let me do it.
Yeah.
What's camp been like, man?
It's been awesome.
What's your favorite part so far?
The messages. The church.
Elaborate.
What about the messages? Been awesome.
I don't know, it's like, you know.
I don't know what to say.
Sweet.
How's your experience been?
Are you going to cut everything?
How has your life been changed so far this week?
closer to God. I feel like I'm closer to God.
Cool.
Yeah. I don't know what else. I guess that's it.
What would you tell someone else if they wanted to come to camp? What would you say to them?
It's a life-changing experience. Like, it really is. Like, it's different. I mean, different from just normal church. You come here and you meet new people and, you know, you learn from another pastor than from what you have at the other church. And, you know,
cool.
Something like that, yeah. Some of the messages kind of freak you out in a way, you know, because, like, you know, it's crazy how this world is and everything and how he puts everything at, you know. Like, there's two sides, you know. If you don't forgive for your sins or whatever and change your life, you're going to be a slave, you know, for hell. And then if you change and you forgive God, your forgiveness and everything, you'll be with him. And if you stay like the way, you'll stay on his side. So, yeah, that's about it.
You hitting your nose?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Are you trying to take my...
Talk about Kim.
It's amazing.
What's amazing about it?
Getting closer to God, meeting new people, really getting closer to God, like getting rid of any, or facing any problems you realize that have been in their way, and becoming closer and developing a better relationship with God.
What's your best part so far?
Best part so far? The water day.
Why?
So it's soaking wet, and it was fun to watch Keenan wear a turban all day.
That's kidding. Is that going?
Alright, dude. Look at my favorite part of my camp so
far. The chicks! Here! You told me to say it. Here's the money for that.
Chicks. Favorite part of camp so far?
My favorite part so far has probably been the sermons, because the youth pastor, he's so energetic, really gets your attention, and he really makes you look at things from a different perspective, and you kind of take a step back and say, wow, and I've never looked at it like that. And he explained things in such a way that it's like, wow, I really understand that now, and now I know what to do and what steps to take to, you know, go forth and change my life in that way. So that's probably been the best part for me.
What else?
What else?
Anything else? You guys have a hug?
I don't know. It was so much fun getting Miss Mary soaked. That was definitely worth it. Every minute of it.
You got to ride home with her, right?
Yeah. Yeah, sadly.
Lauren, what's your favorite part about camp?
Lauren,
it's
Lauren!
Tell me when you're ready.
Whenever you're ready.
Can I videotape you, bro?
I think eventually
you're going to
be on the
right. Do you want to see me? Sure.
We're not related to him in any way. Not at all.
That's me.
What has camp experience been like for you?
It's been awesome. Let me show you why. Let me show you. Over here.
No, I can't do that.
It's Lauren White. And she's so wanted to be on TV. And so, Lauren, how has camp been?
Lauren!
Hey, there she is! It's been great. Because Skylar's here. And Dakota's here. And Shelby is here. Yay! And Jenny Stover is the best chaperone in the world. And June's hot. And
oh my God!
It's on video. And this dude right here, he's got hair.
And Brad doesn't.
So anyway, it's been a great week. And so, later.
Where are you, Keenan?
Oh, sorry.
He's recording.
Not on that part yet. He's gotta play the guitar.
listening.
Jordan, what did you?
Say what you need to say. 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 Say what you need to say.
Yeah?
Say what you need to say.
Say it.
I'm done.
Wait, like, what did you say?
You have to go.
Water.
Water.
Oh, I have.
Do you want your
no.
Up what?
You're gonna order a French toast steak and a small dose of pepper.
Really?
He did.
Already did.
Joking around.
Not cutting my hair here.
I don't. That was awesome.
Hey. How you doing?
I'm about to tell this dude what's up.
Hey. Hey, Tim, come here. Let's just take a soothing session right now. Get in the camera. Get in front of the camera. In front of the camera.
Do it.
Come on, come here. Come here, soothing session. Hey.
This is I hate camp. I hate camp.
What is on my eyes?
That could have been dangerous for you. Are you aware of that?
How do you get my kind of burger?
I ordered large because we can share. Otherwise, I would probably have said something already.
Your love, oh.